Hello.
Hey, I saw this ad about an apartment for rent. Is it still available?
Oh yeah, that apartment? Yeah.
Is it still available?
Well, it's kind of available.
So, have you signed a lease with anyone?
No, not yet.
Can I still submit an application, just in case?
Yeah, you can, but I gotta be honest with you, man. I'm looking for someone long-term, someone professional, someone who has good credit. You know what I mean?
I do. I meet those qualifications, that's why I'm here. I have a professional job, I have good credit.
I guess you can apply if you have $60 for the application.
Sure, I'll drop my check and email you my application.
What the hell, man? Hello and welcome to Entrepreneur Extraordinaire. Hola, ¿cómo estás? Salam, konnichiwa, namaste to all my friends all over the world. So what you saw today in this role-playing video, played by yours truly, myself, is showing the reality of real estate. A very arrogant landlord is trying his best to stop this black man from getting his apartment. If you notice, there were some subtle clues in this video where he's discouraging this person. For example, when he asked him, you know, is the apartment available? And he's kind of giving him wishy-washy answers, even charging him a $60 application fees. Who charges $60 for an application? And this is not just this video, folks. This is the reality that I see in the real estate market. None of your YouTubers, the big names, you know, Stephen Graham or, you know, meet Kevin and those guys. None of these big names are making, you know, videos on these topics. And this is the topic people should talk about. In fact, when I went on YouTube, I did not see very many videos. And I'm surprised in this industry where there's so much going on against the race, against religion, against your ethnicity, against the skin, the color of your skin, is not being talked about in these videos. And that bothered me enough to make this video for you guys. So I hope you guys can appreciate where this is coming from. Let's start with the history of real estate. Let's start with what happened. Let's start with 1930s, where there was a law written in the law books by the Homeowners Loan Association or Loan Corporation, where they segregated people, where they drew maps, and they clearly stated the law. The law in 1930s was, you can't get a home mortgage unless you're Caucasian. That's what it says in the law. You can't get it if you're black, if you're born in this country, doesn't matter. If you're Asian, if you're Latino. In fact, they went in so far as they created this map, this elaborate map called redlining in this day and age in the 1930s. What is redlining? This Homeowners Loan Corporation designed a map where they marked all areas in four different categories. And let me share those categories so you can understand what redlining is about, because a lot of banks are following those policies. So they divvy up the US map in four different categories, namely the green zone, the blue zone, the yellow zone, and the red zone. The green zone was for the people who are businessmen. You know, in this day and age, it would be, you know, big shots like, you know, Elon Musk or Tim Cook and so on and so forth. Now, then there's a blue zone where there's a blue collar worker living in the blue zone. For example, someone who may work for IBM's. Now, there's a yellow zone. The yellow zone is for people who are the working class Americans. For example, someone who drives the truck in this day and age. And then there's the red zone. So the red zone was called the hazardous zone, meaning you should not be lending loans to these hazardous zones. And these hazard zones were comprised of ethnicities, for example, blacks, Latinos, people of foreign origin, immigrants, Asians. So that is the concept of redlining. Now, from 1930s till 1968, this law just kept going on. In fact, George Romney, who was the father of the current governor, Mitt Romney of Utah, tried to come up with a law to bridge the gap and then create more integration of societies. But guess what Nixon did? Nixon stopped the effort, folks.
Concerning Governor Romney's plan, to what extent should the federal government use its leverage to promote racial integration in suburban housing?
It is not the policy of this government to use federal funds in any other way, in ways not required by the law, for forced integration of the suburbs. I believe that forced integration of the suburbs is not in the national interest.
Not good for the country? I mean, people living in the same communities is not good for the country? Are you kidding me? Imagine how racist this sounds Well, it turns out that this person himself, Nixon, did not turn out to be good for the country. And we know what happened with Nixon. I don't want to get into that, but you get the idea. But that's where the racism in real estate started, people, because these people did not want blacks and Asians and Latinos, people of color, brown people, black people, let's just call them brown people, you know, did not want them to integrate in the community, in the society. They wanted to control the distribution of wealth, so it stays in a certain community, in a certain sector. The rich wanted to be rich, and the poor, they wanted to keep them poor. And who could they control easily? People who don't have mortgages. Think about it for a second, right? Back in the day, you know, 60 some years ago, only if you're Caucasian, you can get a home loan, meaning you can put a payment down that can give you $80,000, $90,000 loan. How do people create wealth? People create wealth by buying houses, and the house appreciates over time, okay? Decades to pay off that loan. So you have this much leverage if you're white 60 years ago. And then after 60 years, then you're saying that, oh, by the way, if you're black or Latino or person of color or brown, you can also get a loan. Really? So you've put me behind 60 years and now you're saying you can get a loan? Think about how huge disadvantage that is if you are a person of color. Now, when I went to school, my teacher told me, AK, so what? You're an immigrant. It may take you twice as long to understand something that a white person who was born here can read in 2 minutes and get it. And I understand that. But after putting in all this work and effort, I would not be here talking to you if these laws still exist. So think about the dynamics of this issue. And that's how deep racism was embedded in the culture of US, in the fabric of the society. If you are black or brown, you have to work twice as much to get half as much. And numbers don't lie, folks. Let's look at the population of black and Hispanics and Asians and how many houses they own versus the white community, right? So 45% for blacks versus 75% for if you're white. That's a huge disparity. And that disparity comes from the point that I made earlier, which is, you know, you gave me a 30 to 60 year head start and I'm behind. How am I supposed to catch up? Work twice as hard to get half as much? That is atrocity. Now let's fast forward, okay? Let's fast forward up to 2021. The current president, Joe Biden, seems like a nice guy, but he says to the American public that I'm gonna give everybody $15,000 as a first year home buyer credit. First home buyer credit of $15,000. But here's the problem, folks. For everyone, oh, wait a minute. You gave everyone else a 60-year start, and now you're telling me because I'm brown and I'm black that you're gonna give everybody $15,000? Well, what about the minorities? How are we gonna catch up this 60 years of gap when I could not get a loan, when everybody else who looked like you had a loan, had leverage, was able to create wealth over time? How am I supposed to catch up with that? With $15,000? $15,000 is nothing, folks. It's a drop in the bucket. It's nice of him to say that, but it's too little, too late. There has to be a massive effort to gain the amount of wealth that was lost by people. People's properties were taken away from them, folks. I'm not making this up. You can Google this. There's a Bruce Beach called in Huntington, which was taken by a person who bought it for $15,000 back in 1930s, okay? And this beach is now owned by the government. So I want you to pay attention to this, folks, because there's a lot of racism going on even today in this market. Let me share with you a poster from 1960s, which was posted all over the streets. This is not too long ago. This is not hundreds of thousands of years ago. This is just 1960s. And the poster says, "We want white tenants." Say it with me. We want white tenants. White tenants? How racist does that sound? What if I were to say that I only want brown tenants around me? How would you feel about that? That is so, so wrong in so many levels, folks. But that was the norm because the law says you can't get a home mortgage loan. How am I supposed to make a house payment of a $100,000 house or $80,000 house back in the day? How am I supposed to buy that house? But that was the norm back in the day. And by the way, this video is not for my white friends who are professionals, who are educated, who understand the effects of racism, systemic racism in the society, okay? So I don't want to offend anybody who's watching this channel and understand. This is for people who are in denial. People who are in denial who don't understand what racism is and how it affects the rest of us. When I get a ticket, The officers often write me up as a Caucasian person because, you know, well, the color of my skin is more white than brown or black. But I'm not white, I'm a brown person. And if you want to watch my story, you can go to entrepreneurextraordinaire.com and see my story. Even on my channel, there's a video about how I came here 25 years ago and I'm a self-made millionaire and so on and so forth through much trials and tribulations. Did not happen in one day, took a long time. But when people see me outside, they think I'm white, and that's why I can get away with a lot in terms of, you know, having access to loans, having access to mortgages, being able to talk and communicate because I have college education. And that's why I get treated a bit differently than someone who has a darker skin, darker color, not as professional sounding and so on and so forth. By the way, if you like such content, if you care about this topic, please share this video with other people that you know so they can also understand what's going on under the hood of the society. Know your history so you can change your future. And for those of you who are watching here, you are the future if you're watching this video. Let me give you another example, okay? When a black person, and this is, I can show you a clip from ABC or NBC News where they did a research skit on a black person putting their house for appraisal, and they get $100,000 less appraisal than a white person.
The first is my administration has launched an aggressive effort to combat racial discrimination in housing. That includes everything from redlining to the cruel fact that a home owned by a black family is too often appraised at a lower value than a similar home owned by a white family.
Again, it's the distribution of wealth. I don't want to give wealth to everybody. I want to keep the wealth to myself. Now, LBJ in 1968 changed the laws to now say that redlining is effectively illegal, but it was on paper, it's a policy. Let me give you another example. To this day, a lot of brokerage companies, guess what they do? This is a systemic practice that exists in all brokerage companies, and most of them, they send the black and Latino agents to the low-income communities to sell houses there. So now you might say, okay, so what? What's the problem here? I don't see a problem here. Well, there's a big problem, folks. And the problem is that if I'm a black agent or a brown agent and I'm only selling a house that's worth $300,000, but a white agent is being sent to a $1 million house community, they have twice as much more commission than I do. How am I supposed to compete with that? This systemic racism exists and is growing because it's so easy to do. It's easy to give somebody an assignment and send them off to a neighborhood so they go and they sell houses in the neighborhood and they're being told, well, you understand this community better than anybody else, so you must go there and sell the house. What's the big deal? And especially the young ones who don't understand discrimination, they're going there and they're thinking, hey, I'm still making money, but they're not making the same kind of money as everybody else. The same thing happens to women versus men. So how am I supposed to compete with somebody who's selling a $1 million house? I will never be able to compete with that. It's embedded in the culture and the fabric of real estate. Let's give you a realistic example of a city, Chicago, a beautiful city, and I've been there many times. Chicago is the most segregated city probably in the entire United States, if not the top ones. There's a south side of Chicago where all the black people live, all the ethnicities of color live. Then there's a north side or the east side where all the white people are living. Where do you think they send the black agents to? On the south side of Chicago, not the east side. So the damage to the society is that these people never get to mingle and socialize with any of the other side, the blue, the yellow zones, the green zones. They never get to mingle and mix. The kids never understand. And that's why the separation continues and it keeps going in different directions. Even up till 2015, a bank in Wisconsin was found guilty and they had to pay a fine of $20 million because they had built systemic racism in their system to deny people of color loans and mortgages. Wow, that still happens in this day and age? The Fair Housing Association have often sent people on surveys and investigations and found that the blacks and Latinos were shown 17.7% less houses than their white counterparts. So how am I supposed to even buy a house if you're going to show me less houses? A white person making $30,000 can live in the same neighborhood because of the loan and leverage, right? As a black or Hispanic person who's making $100,000. I have 60% more income than you, but you can afford to live in the same neighborhood as I am because I'm getting a higher mortgage interest rate. You see how the game is played? Yes, I will tag you on your credit. I will tag you on the interest rate. I will make sure I bring your status down as low as possible because you're a person of color. And this happens equally to Asians, to immigrants, to foreign-born nationals, to people who are black or brown, Indians, Pakistanis, doesn't really matter, Arabs. So as an investor in real estate, think about that. If you're doing door knocking or bird dogging and you wanna get houses so you can invest and flip and invest and so on and so forth, what are your chances you knock on the door and you're black? Your name is Umar. You might get shot at the door because you're on my property. You might get the door slammed in your face. Someone might unleash a dog on you, right? So what would encourage me to go do that? To be an investor in door knocking, to ask people if they want to sell their house, or be an agent, or any other business? How can I integrate in the community where you treat me differently? Just like you saw in my video, right? You don't qualify because you're black. Your skin color is much darker than mine. So you may not fit in this community because you talk different. So let me go ahead and play a video for you of a real estate agent in California who's harassing this Asian female.
And you're a stupid blue Asian haired girl.
Really?
Yeah. Hey.
Now, as you saw this man harassing this Asian woman, this white man, this video went viral because this lady took a risk and posted it on her Twitter. And this guy eventually got fired because he got so much social pressure. But these agents are walking around out there, right? They're racist agents, but they're walking around everywhere because they feel entitled. They feel they have the white privilege. They think everybody else is dumb and they should go back to their country. This country was built by immigrants on the back of blacks and many other ethnicities. So how can you say somebody who's born here in this country, go back to your country when this is their country? But this is a recent video that just gives you chills on your down your spine, because just you think about like, wow, this is happening today. As I sit here and I talk to you, somebody out there is being discriminated because not everybody has the braveness to put those videos out there and show discrimination. So the question becomes, what can I do as a person? You're asking me, AK, well, you're telling me all these things, all these facts, they sound good. You show me the numbers, show me the video clips. What do I do with this information? Here's what you can do, because I've thought about it a lot, folks. I've thought about it and I asked myself this question, what can I do? I'm making this video for you guys. I'm making this video so you guys can understand, know some history so you can change the future. I'm not black. I don't get discriminated as much or half as much as most of the people that we're talking about. But I took the time to research for almost a week to come up with this content to share with you guys. So what you can do is share the video, like and subscribe to this kind of content, participate. The best thing you can do with social media is create awareness. Put some comments to share your feelings so people understand how you feel. Share your story with other people. Because sometimes I read a lot of comments and I'm like, wow, this person went through this and nobody knew about it. Share that story. Tell us what you went through. Tell us what your pain points are. Tell us if you have been discriminated. Share that story with the world. Who cares if people don't like it? It's your life. It's your country. You know, expose any real estate agents who discriminate you. If you go somewhere and they don't give you the loan at the highest rate possible, at the lowest rate possible, then you need to complain, file a complaint. And if you see somebody at work being discriminated or being bullied because they are of a darker race or color, file a complaint with HR. You can do your part, but if you stay quiet, that means you're part of the problem. You're part of the society and you accept it. You can change the world if you raise a voice against what's happening, but you cannot change the world if you just stay quiet. Staying quiet and taking it all in is not an option anymore, folks. We're in 2021. You have a voice. Call your radio station. You know, call your TV station, whomever you listen to, people you admire. I'm sure there's many people you admire. Ask them to talk about these topics. Lastly, I want to thank my friend Curtis. I want to thank my friend Rebecca for letting me use their picture for the thumbnail. Look at the thumbnail. It's a beautiful thumbnail that I designed. So racism in real estate, folks, it still exists. So again, know your history to change the future. Don't accept things as they are. Change things, because you have the power to change it. Until then, have a great day. I'll see you next time in my next video. Bye.